flounder. Sitting here trying to catch croaker bait.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah, of course, I think I caught you too. Yeah, I did.
Moved off the big D.
Yeah, there we go.
Yeah, you got a little flounder.
It's nice. It's very respectable. Not a keeper, I don't think. It's very respectable. Hadn't been here 5 minutes. Yeah, we're going to let him go. Absolutely.
And we're just trying to catch croaker just so we can go catch some bigger flounder.
Right, absolutely. There we go. My favorite wrecks, the Big D, the mile, also known as the Milepost 6 wreck, and we've got a beautiful flounder, one of our favorite flounder holes right here. This is, I believe, a keeper flounder. Let me get him in the boat. Ooh. Look at that. Just gorgeous, gorgeous flounder. One of the better flounders we've caught all year. And he hit on a fluke rig. Topped off with a live menhaden. Look at that. Beautiful, beautiful fish. We're fishing right on top of the wreck, 32 feet of water, and the depth that we're fishing is probably only about 16 feet. This wreck is an old crane that actually sunk and got knocked over. I don't believe it was a hurricane, but it was a very, very, very bad storm, nor'easter. And this is definitely a keeper flounder. A little bit of dental work here. Don't want to lose that rig. Now the menhaden that we caught, we just caught right at our marina, right at Customs House Marina. Right before we got out here. Come out here in the bay, I'll tell you, they just, you can catch anything on them. But right here, this is a beautiful flounder. Just gorgeous. Fat, healthy fish. And this this wreck that we're fishing sank, I believe it was on the Ash Wednesday storm. And it's a big crane underwater, but that is a beautiful keeper flounder. And caught him right on top of the wreck. We always do well on flounder whenever we come out here. But sometimes it's hard to get set up on it. But today we don't have a whole lot of current right now. And we're able to maintain right above the wreck. And we'll fish both the top of it. Right now we're drifting just off of it, 33 feet of water. So we're going from 33 feet to 17 feet. And it's a good way to start the day. So what we got here, look at all of the fish right here following. Look at all the spadefish. There's a whole school of spadefish following this flounder. Look at all those spadefish. Isn't that beautiful? We caught another beautiful keeper flounder, and there's a whole school of spadefish coming right up here. Now that we know that the spadefish are here over top of this wreck, this is the Big D, we can put out some lines for spadefish. So right now we're catching spadefish, beautiful keeper flounder. Look, when the flounder just splashed, you can see the spadefish just totally go all over the place. Another beautiful flounder. Here you go, Tina. Look, another flounder. Pretty flounder, and boy, do we have spadefish here. Lots of spadefish. So we'll set out some spadefish rigs, as well as flounder fishing. Tina, do you see the flounder? That's another beautiful flounder. Speaking, we'll show you what we've been keeping here, catching. A couple of beautiful Big D flounder. Milepost 6 wreck. Bay Bridge Tunnel, and we're getting ready to catch a whole mess of spadefish. All right, Tina, we're gonna put them back in. There we go. Good fish, right, Tina? Let's show you the bait that we're using. Right over here, we brought with us. Again, we caught right from Customs House Marina. Just some little menhaden that we caught right at the dock on a fluke rig, and boy, are these flounder tearing them up. Now we're right on the ledge of the wreck. So where these flounder are laying is in the sandy bottom, right on the ledges of this underwater crane. And there's just tons of spadefish here. So looking forward to go ahead and getting up a rig and catching some spadefish.
How to snell a hook, Captain Bill.
All right, we're gonna, the line comes up through the bottom of the hook. You just run it back through that same hole. And if you see, we got a little loop there. And what you want to do is, you see I got the loop sort of held with my fingertip. This is some pretty heavy line. Then we just want to take that line and go around the hook. Hold on just 1 second there. We still got this rig hooked up to the rod and I don't want to hook myself. There we go. If you notice, I'm running the line from the top toward the bottom while I hold that little loop. It's 3 turns, 4 turns, 5 turns is probably good enough. So I've got a little tag end. I want to run that tag through that loop I held with my fingers for a few minutes. And just, you can see, I'm just holding it down and pulling with the other end of the line. And see how it comes up? There you go. And you got a snell. We clip that off and we're good to go.
There you go.